vice president or a CEO, we have a tag? Everybody of us? Is there anybody who don't have a tag? Is there anybody here who don't have a tag? We have tags. And those tags become our identity. I would like to remind you, those tags are not your identity. Those tags are after you were born. Agree with me or not? Please, for the next half an hour, or maybe an hour, or up to this meeting, keep your tags on the table. Keep your tag, mental tag of this name on the table, and think as a human being. Only then we can connect more closely. Only then you can take out the best out of this thing. Connect with, on a human being's level, not on a level of HR, senior, vice president, CEO, or director. So are you ready to put your tags on the table? It is very difficult for some people because sometimes they are too attached to us that many times when we remove the tags, we think we are removing the clothes. They are so close to our heart, you know. So I would like you to keep your tags on the table and don't forget to take the tag back when you go back. Right? So please put your tags on the table, then we can talk heart to heart leader. Agree with me? Back. You can't develop leaders if you are not leaders yourself. So I am not going to the territory of leadership, I am going into the territory of personal leadership. Now what does this mean? Because, you know, I am talking about emotions and feelings and all kind of stuff. So I am going deep into the personal leadership area. Personal leadership in your life, in your personal, in your professional life, everything. But see this. There are some aspects of personal leadership which I am going to discuss. This will help not only to you and your organization, but your families and your generations. See this. First aspect, number one, be the change you want to see in the world. Have you heard this statement before? Back. Right back. Have you heard this statement before? Now, do you know how to apply it? I want to change the world. But before changing the world, I need to change myself. So that's what it's said in the scriptures and everywhere. But how you can do in HR, let me tell you. If you say something to your employees and don't follow, your trust is broken. Many times sales guys, what they do? They are calling the phone. Okay. I'm just on the corner, sir. I'm just coming. And he is sitting just 20 kilometers away and he is saying to the guy, I'm just on the corner. Okay, it's perfectly okay, it's a professional world. But when you are saying this in front of your kids, when you are sitting at home, you are doing a blunder. You are telling your kid, beta, it is okay to lie. It is okay. You can also lie to me. Then when he goes out somewhere in the night, you say, where have you gone? He said, I was studying with my, you know, pal. And you can't say anything because he has learned this from you. Because you are always on the Bluetooth or something. Okay, I'm just right there. I'm stuck in the traffic. The roads are bad. That's why really, you know, that be the change you wanted to see in the world. Your employees are watching you very carefully. Understand this. They are watching your each and every step. Whether inside the company or outside the company. So beware. Beware of this thing. Second aspect of leadership is this. From now onwards, see this, nobody in the world is wrong. Nobody in the world is wrong. Everybody is right in his or her perspective. This is a revolution. The moment I knew this concept 5 years back, the complete life has changed for me. Before that I thought, I am right, he is wrong. Or why people do wrong things? Nobody in the world do wrong things. They do the things which seems wrong to you and they do the things which might be wrong to you, but this is not their intention to do the wrong thing. What you can do? Whenever a person has done a mistake or something, you know, committed a blunder, after knowing this, you know that he has not committed this blunder intentionally. Agree with me or not? Agree with me? The moment you know this principle, then you are going to his shoes and trying to understand why he has done this. Why he has committed this mistake, this blunder, which can cost his job. Why he has done this? That's the part of leadership. Third.